was Gucci Baby, Team King of Gangs in this thing. And we also have my man James from Team FTK. This is my boy Carlos. Today he did pretty good. So what you running, bro?
I'm running Kaijuzu, but I signed the Kaijuzu.
That's interesting. Let's do this.
All right. For the most part, it's actually a pretty standard list. Three rat.
You might turn them the other way?
Not at all. Three rat, obvious. If you don't know what this card does, you're not playing Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yeah, because everybody plays it.
Yeah, so three rat. Three whiptail.
That's what I'm talking about. Clutch.
Banishing, and it's just extra damage to push for those OTKs.
It's like the most standalone Zodiac.
Yeah.
It's
just, one Thoroughblade hardly ever came up. I actually thought almost about cutting it, in general. But it's just one more Zodiac monster that could get you into those Zodiac combos if you don't draw any of the tankies for some godforsaken reason. Any of your rats, tankies, barrage, whatever. And you get that piercing damage, so when you're in like time or something like that, you can poke if they have like something in defense and still do some damage. So it's good for that one. I wouldn't run anymore. One's good. Three OP.
Yeah. I hate that card, man.
Two OP, and of course with him comes the Target on board.
Bro, tell them about the time this guy won.
Oh yeah, sure. So I was playing a match against Invoke Ritual Beast. And the guy was at 2,100 life points. I think he had like dimensional buried me or something. The point is, I had searched out my Tali Tomborg off of my Terra Top, but I didn't play it because I wasn't going to be able to go into the XE, so I kept it. He had 2,100 at some point. He saw him strike like my Whiptail that I summoned or something. I was going to go off into a combo with that. And he was left at 600. And he had forgotten that I had searched the Tali Tomborg the last turn. And so I go normal. Attack for game because he had like one back row.
Best card in the game.
Yeah, best card.
Best card in the game.
OP wins games if your opponent decides to solemn strike. So yeah, this came in clutch one game. I kept it in my hand instead of like summoning it. So
did you suffer from the curse of always having that in your hand?
It's not really a curse. Because if you have it in your hand, then it's just like, okay, I'm not going to search it. And yeah, you get one less card, because this could have been something else, and then you can search this, that. But I mean, it's not like you break or anything. You can still do your Invoker combos. You're just going to have a minus one card. But you still get Invoker, and that in itself is a lot already. So yeah, I don't mind drawing this. Obviously, it's ideal not to, but it's okay if you do. Two Ghost Ogre.
Mm-hmm.
For the Tigers, for the the mirror match, anything else, just disrupt your opponent's place. Really good.
Did you guys know that used to be a boy?
Yeah. Two Maxi, OP.
Why you in a Maxi?
You got it in this format. That's, if you're not running, then you're not playing Yu-Gi-Oh. One Luna Light.
Lord.
If you haven't heard about this combo, then I don't know what you're doing. But again, this one lets you essentially go do the zoo combo a second time, first turn, or whenever you search this out. Instead of searching out the Whiptail off of your Broadbowl, you search this. Go into the fusion substitute, fusion your Broadbowl and your Digusto. Get Norden, bring back the rat, and then hard summon Broadbowl to redo your combo, because you shuffled back your other rats with the first Digusto. And the plus of that is not that you do the combo twice, but it's that you go Digusto twice, right? So
that's,
you draw
legit.
Two instead of one. And then on top of that, the fusion substitute can be banished from grave to return a fusion. You return Norden and draw a third. So you do you still end up with the same board. You go Dryden, Digusto, and then if you had the Invoker or Totembird. But the difference is, because you cycled the combo twice, you now drew two off of Digusto, and then you get the third draw off of fusion substitute. Really good. Lets you set up your board and then hopefully draw into your back row. Triple Barrage, you have to. I mean, it's Zoo. It's
correct.
It's a free rat. And if not a rat, one of your other Zoos. Three tanky, same reason for the Barrage.
Bro, top deck genius, man.
Oh yeah, I was playing a match, and I had no board, no hand, and we were in time. I was turn five, and I top decked this card. I could have won the duel, but I misplayed. But still, that was
One card brought him back.
Yeah, one card could have saved me. So it's crazy. This card's really good. I sometimes prefer this over the barrage because you get the normal off of the rat, and that lets you send combo, which only helps you, you know, recycle your Zodiac monsters back. You know, so sometimes a tanky is even better than barrage. Two Chalice. Spell negation is really cool. Really neat thing that I do, a lot of people don't realize, is sometimes when I'm attacking for game and I'm just shy of the game, I'll chalice my own monster, and then my opponents don't see it coming. I don't know why.
Man, that extra 400.
Yeah, you would think it'd be, you know, people would know more about that, but yeah, you chalice your own monster. If you for some reason don't have the OTK, you get it there with the extra 400. To my body.
Yep.
Everybody's running Boldwise because of Zeus. Yeah. Everybody's running, you know, the Kaiju engine. The
Slumber, man.
Yeah, Slumber, Regeki, everything. So, you know, this is for that kind of stuff. Stops Ghost Ogre. A lot of people don't know that.
Oh, yeah, that's legit.
Stops Ghost Ogre. Stops Toad. I mean, he still gets to return a frog, but, you know, negate the Toad. So you set this, and they think you're going to bait out the Toad, and you're like, nope, negate your Toad, still go with my effect. So really good. I actually used this in a Paleo match today.
Paleos.
One Regeki, two Dark Holes. You have to. Zeus a thing. It's the most popular deck. You have to board wipe them. And it's just good in general to have board wipes in this format. There's a lot of decks that just spam out monsters like it's water or something.
Right.
So you got to run the board wipes. One instant. I used to run two. I don't like that the second one's dead in the grave. With this, even with the Luna Light combo, you still don't use instant twice because you're hard summoning the Norden off of your fusion substitute, right?
Right.
And so, yeah, the one's fine. I didn't like the two. I get that people want to draw it more, but I'd rather run other cards than two.
Gotcha.
Instants. Double Twin. I don't like the Cyclone. I don't like the MST. I don't like the other one? Night Beam.
This
is good. Just activate it during end phase. They can chain their barriers if they want. Nothing's going to happen. so, you know, still run this. You still get two. You just got to do it during the end phase. Twin Twister is still the better back row removal. The Fusion Substitute for the Luna Light combo, you know, gets banished it from grave, return Norden, get the extra draw. That's how you get the three draws off of the Luna Light combo. Three of the real lose one turn.
The real lose one
the
turn.
The real lose one turn. Three-dimensional barriers, you know, essentially stop your opponent. A lot of people are running anti-meta decks, and so they'll run decks that can go synchro and fusion, or, you know, synchro Xyz or Xyz fusion or whatever. But this still stops a lot of the combo. Otherwise, they'd be able to go into both their combos. And so,
right.
Dimensional barrier is still really good. I only play going first, though. I hated going second. Yeah, the game's so fast-paced right now that if you draw this first turn, sure, you can set it, and it's still a good card, but you're already playing a turn behind. So
right.
I'd rather especially see a card that's good first turn. I usually cite all my Solemns with my barriers. Speaking of Solemns, Double Strike.
Question. Only two?
Only two. I think two's good. I never felt like I needed a third.
Is it because of the My Bodies?
You have a life point cost from My Bodies, and then you have this, and then I'm also running a Warning, so it's already a lot of life point cost. And, you know, I never absolutely needed a third. If I ever needed a third, it would have probably cost me the duel, because I'm just paying too many life points. Two is fine.
Right, I understand.
You don't run three. If you're running three, don't run Warning. But the thing is, you gotta run Warning, because there's always the decks that, you know, are going to do the non-inherit summon, so you
right.
need that Warning just in case. You can't Solemn Strike, you know, Invocation or something like that, so you need Warning if they don't have the Meltdown on field. The one Warning,
right.
Like I said, that's for non-inherit summons. It would be three strikes, but I like having two strikes in this, because that just gives you the extra ability to, you know, stop those summons from
right.
The ritual cards or the fusion cards. It's an extra 500 life points, but that's just the cost you gotta pay.
It's too good, man.
Yeah,
Warning's way too good.
Yeah, that's just the cost you gotta pay. One, I'm a win.
One vanity speaks for itself.
Yeah, I won. Yeah, this card, when I played this card, I won. You have to run. Yeah, if you're not running this, you're not gonna win.
Yeah, strange. A lot of people aren't running Warning and Vanities in their main deck. Like, I've seen a lot of pure Zoos that don't run this. I don't know why.
Yeah, I don't get it. I like this card. I was running it last format. I'm running it this format. You set board, you pass, you activate during their standby, and you know it's 95% of the time that's GG.
Yep.
This card wins you games. One combo.
Yeah.
You got to recycle your pieces back.
Absolutely.
This deck runs out of gas so fast. You got to always send this to the grave somehow. Either offer your Twin Twisters. A lot of people don't remember that. Like, sometimes you draw into this, and if you have a Twin Twister, you can just ditch it off of that. Some people forget about that. But, you know, most of the times what you're doing is you're ditching it to the grave from the deck, off of the normal summon from the rat.
Right.
So, you know, that's good. That's why I prefer Tanky sometimes over the Barrage, just because, you know, you get to send that combo, and then that helps you, especially in grind games, you know, games like Paleo and stuff like that. Last but not least, Torrential Tribute. Really good card, another board wipe. The difference is, unlike Regeki and Dark Holes, you can obviously activate this during your opponent's turn if they summon. And so that's really good. Sometimes you want to wait out and see what they're going to do before you decide to board wipe. So, really good card. On to the extra deck. Here, let me put this together.
Got it.
So I'm running the one boar. Boar's good. You get to, you know, that the attack directly comes in clutch sometimes, especially in time. So that's really good. Or maybe if you have enough attacks, it's just like go over your opponent's monster or something like that. Or maybe you don't want to destroy if you're playing the Metaphor matchup. You don't want to, because they set the counters. So you just, you know, attack directly instead. Really good. Just comes in clutch in so many different scenarios. I'm running... sorry about that.
That's all good.
Two Tigers, pretty standard. Lets you get your rats back from grave in case you didn't shuffle one of them back. Also, just, you know, if you go board Tiger, that's what enables your entire zoo combo. It allows you to get the search eventually, because, you know, you have that extra piece with the boar and,
right,
and stuff. So, you know, that's that. Two Broad Bull. Really good, searches out your Whiptail, searches out the Luna Light. So your
combo, oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So the Luna Light combo always happens if you open up the regular Zodiac combo. And the really cool thing about it is that, yeah, you are running two extra cards, but those two extra cards get searched out through the combo. And so you thin out your deck to 40 by the end of your first turn anyways. And you get the three draws. It's not really, so it's, you know, you're not really making your deck any bigger, because you're going to thin it out through the combo anyways. So you're still running a 40 card deck, you know, with, you know, the two extra cards, they just get thinned out. Yeah, also lets you go into your Whiptail so you can banish or just get more attack. So yeah, or Broad Bull. And we have two of the boss. Dryden.
Yeah, roadkill.
Yeah, it is, only because the deck is so consistent. ABC Buster was better than this, but that deck is obviously way slower than this deck. And because of the speed and the consistency of this deck, this card is broken. You know, you're always going to start off with, you know, disrupting your opponent if you go second.
Yeah.
So, you know, really good.
So the standard zoo lined up pretty
much
for the extra deck.
Yeah, so it's one boar and two beat. Some people run two boar. I was having trouble with extra deck space, so I ran the one boar.
Got it.
You know, sometimes I kind of miss the boar, but you can play around and you have to sacrifice your surge or maybe sacrifice attaching with the tiger from grave. But most of the times you can afford that, so running one boar is fine.
Okay.
And of course, with that comes the double digusto.
Standard.
Yeah, pretty standard. You have to recycle. Like I said, this deck runs out of gas really quick, so you have to get the double digusto. Double digusto, infinite digusto, keep bringing himself back. And then we have, for the rank threes off of the Terror Top combos, we have MX Saber Invoker and Totem. If you already have the combo in your hand, you go Totem just to, you know, negate stuff.
Right.
If you don't have the combo, then obviously you have to go Invoker special your rat or even your other Zodiac monsters if you needed to.
Okay.
So yeah, these are the rank two. No Breaksword. I don't like Breaksword. I feel like most duels, you're only going into either one of these two. And if you go into Breaksword, you're going to have to recycle back your Totem Bird if you want to go into these later on. And you can do that, but ideally you want to be recycling your Zodiacs because you want your engine to keep going, right?
Right.
So no brakes or no other rank 3s, these two.
Okay.
If you already have the combo, you go this. If you don't, you have that. So use it for the combo. One Norton.
Yeah, for the combo.
Really clutch with the Luna Light combo. Something that people overlook is that when you hard summon him off of the combo, he doesn't go to grave. Everybody's so used to him going to grave because they always instant fusion him.
Right.
Right. And so you get him on board and he can attack. And so even if they disrupt your combo during this play, you still get the three draws because at that point in the combo, you've already gone through your first Digusto, or you get two draws. You've gone through your first Digusto and your fusion, so you get two draws and you get a Norton on field. So a Norton
right.
in back row is not the worst case scenario anyways.
Understand.
You draw into your vanities and you got a 2000 beater, or not a beater, but a 2000 monster. You know, that's actually pretty good. So it's not bad. I'd still argue the Luna Light over not running it. Steel Storm Roach. I did not play any Infernos today. And so I never went into this, I never made this, never had to. But yeah, really good against that matchup. One Castel.
Mm-hmm.
I was running this instead of the Utopia package because this returns the undestroyable Crystal Wing.
Yeah.
So, you know, you just return it to hand. I would run Lightning, I just don't have the space for it. It takes two extra deck space, and I really thought I was going to run into the Inferno matchup. Maybe a little bit more,
right.
But I didn't, and so you know that extra deck spot was for this. Had I known, I wouldn't have played Infernoids that much. Maybe I would have gone Lightning instead, but still really good. Castel still gets rid of the Crystal Wing because it doesn't destroy; it returns. And of course, the OTK card.
Yep.
You go into this when you're going to go into your OTKs. Can attack twice. Targets himself to attack twice. Can do it twice because only one detachment.
All right, let's see that side deck.
GG. Side deck. I run the entire Kaiju engine, so the three, the four Kaijus. This is the lineup: Jisekiro, Dogaran, Gamma Seal, and Thunder King. Some
Got
people
it.
run the Sticky String. I've never ran into problems with, you know, running three, 3K plus, and then one 22. This worked out for me, so I just didn't even try the Sticky String one.
Proceed.
Yeah, so it's that. Of course, with that comes the three slumbers, just more
standard,
board wipes,
right.
Standard. With the third Twin Twister, I almost debated not running this because of Dimensional Barrier, but it's still really good against the Rogue match and, you know, a lot of other decks that for some reason aren't running this. If someone's not running it for whatever reason, this is still good. And like I said, you can still run the three, just activate them during end phase and, you know, they can change the Dimensional Barriers. It's not going to do anything during your turn, so just do it during the end phase. Two Imperial Iron Wall.
Oh, yeah, Infernoids off tops.
Yeah, you can banish. Funny thing, I run that card, and I run two Royal Decrees, and those are the two cards that I run, like, pairs of. And so I was in a Paleo match, and I accidentally sided this in instead of Royal Decree. So
they do kind of look alike.
Well, the thing is, I was running them both in pairs, and so I, like, saw two of them together, and I was like, oh, yeah, these. I should have looked at the card. But, fortunately enough, I still won that duel. So two Imperial Iron Wall for the Infernoids. Cosmos, also good against
right.
Cosmos because they get banished. I actually played a Cosmos, and I opened up this card, and, yeah, I pretty much won that duel because of that. And then the two Royal Decree, of course.
Got it. Let's see the rest of that side deck.
The Paleo. And then lastly, the three anti-spells, Metazoo, Metaphose, Magic Spectres.
Speaking of, bro. Here you go.
So yeah, this is
Thank you, sir.
I hate the pendulum matchup. They can do so much, especially the Metaphose. They can just keep popping.
Yeah, bro, that Metaphose Zoo deck is like, what the heck?
This is just a blowout card for them. You draw this, and they're not gonna do anything. They gotta play, you know their MSTs or Twin Twisters, whatever they're
right.
running, and they're playing at a turn behind. So this slows them down a lot. It's a really good card.
All right, my man.
42 card main, and yeah. One win away from topping, unfortunately, but
you're still a beast, though.
Yeah.
Yes, sir, you are. All right, man. We appreciate you guys. Y'all be safe. Make good choices. Don't hurt your brain cells. Peace.